I printed 3 5x7 photos, and the one in the middle seems to be the most accurate. This is the lighter half of that photograph, and you can see I've got pretty much an accurate match. And that'd be the lighter side of alizarin crimson with chrome oxide green, viridian, and cerulean, and ultramarine right down there. This is the darker, the shaded side of the photograph, and it's just a matter of searching around to find the general mixture of colors for the different values of alizarin and magenta, which will make up my final palette. Cadmium red medium, Venetian red, alizarin crimson, magenta, burnt sienna, and raw sienna. Yellow, light and medium, June brilliant, yellow ochre, cadmium orange, permanent green light, chrome oxide green, viridian, cerulean, ultramarine, and burnt umber. Those make up this palette. I like to do the eyes first and then the mouth, because without those right, the whole thing is going to be wrong. The way to test your values is to put a little paint on the what you've mixed on a white piece of canvas. See, now that's very dark. And it shows up when I add a little bit of flesh tone, makes it lighter. But that's the best way to do it, right on your white canvas pad. You might want to try, it's a piece of plexiglass over the photograph. To get the colors and the values right, you can just use that to match the photograph right there. I just put a little swab of paint there, and it looks like it's pretty good. I think those color choices might be a little bit too warm, so I think I'm going to tone it down a bit. Especially with the highlights. I think the skin tones are just about right now. I changed the background color and the color of the jacket to complement the skin tones of the face. It needs a few more things to touch up and it'd be ready to go. The problem with the expression. I have a problem with the mouth, and it seems to me that it needs to be corrected. It looks like the left side is a little bit too tense, and the way to do that, I think, is to put a shadow below the lip line. I want to get that a little bit below the lip line to make the lip a little bit fuller on the left side. There. This was a very difficult portrait to do. I think I got the skin tones the way I want them, and changed the color of the jacket and the background to complement those colors in the face.